Paul Bunyan's axe has called Madison, Wisconsin home since the early 2000s. The Badgers bring it back to Minnesota today. The Gophers are hoping to keep it in the Twin Cities. And an emotional senior day with a little extra emotion today as former head coach Jerry Kill brings the Gophers out of the tunnel for one final time. BTN Football presented by U.S. Cellular, and today in the battle for Paul Bunyan's axe, the Minnesota Golden Gophers host the Wisconsin Badgers. Kevin Kugler alongside Matt Millen with Lisa Byington on the field. Minnesota playing not only to try to win the axe back, Matt, but they're trying to get themselves eligible for a bowl with a win today.
Yeah, and it's a big game. Because what it states that even though we've had, you know, the coach Kill had to step down and people taking over, there's a little unrest in the program, we're still on track. We still have the players to do it, we still have the coaching staff to do it, and we're going to show it here today.
Minnesota won the toss. They elected to receive the football. Andrew Endicott ready to kick this one off. The junior for the Badgers in the final game of this regular season. And a rivalry that has been so long, it's gone through two different trophies. An axe, and before that, the slab of bacon,
which they lost then found years later.
1994 showed up in a storage room at Camp Randall. We're underway on this final regular season college football Saturday in the Big Ten. Harden looking for a little running room, and he's upended by Andrew Endicott. The kicker makes the tackle, and the Gophers make their way onto the field. And here comes Mitch Leidner, ready to go. 22 career rushing touchdowns. Only Ricky Foggy has had more by a Gopher quarterback in that run game, whether it's from Leidner or Shannon Brooks, something that Minnesota wants to establish today.
They absolutely have to get the run. The team that runs the football best in this game will win.
Motion man is Brandon Lingan on first down. Here's Shannon Brooks with the carry. Brooks met and dropped. Good penetration, knifing in Chikwe Obasi. Just a one-yard pickup on the play.
For those of you who aren't familiar with Shannon Brooks, only making his fifth start, he's a true freshman. He's just, you know, 18 years old, but the kid has a lot of game to him. He's got great quickness and acceleration. He sees the field very, very well. They get him involved in a short passing game, that's another weapon. This kid is a playmaker.
KJ May, another playmaker in motion on second and nine. Leidner to throw, and the pass batted away by Michael Caputo. Those safeties have not gotten enough discussion this year for Wisconsin, both Michael Caputo and Tanner McAvoy.
Yeah, and they ask him to do quite a bit. And you can see right here, he's man-to-man coverage in the tight end. And he has been a stalwart for a long time. It seems like every time you look at Wisconsin, you're talking about Michael Caputo one way or the other.
Third down and nine at the 28. Leidner to Brooks on the edge. And Brooks tripped up as he got to the corner by TJ Edwards, short of a Minnesota first down.
Wisconsin does exactly what they want to do. Stop it on short down, on first down, early downs. Get him into third and long. That's what their game plan will be all day here today.
Martell to punt it away for Minnesota with Alex Erickson back deep. Good punt by Martell. Driving Erickson back to the 14-yard line. And Erickson nowhere to roam. Excellent punt. Good coverage. Duke McGee down there after the 51-yard punt. A 4-yard return for Erickson and a first down for Wisconsin. So now Joel Stavi makes his way onto the field for the first time today. The senior quarterback in his career, almost 7,400 yards, 47 touchdowns. One win away from tying Wisconsin's all-time quarterback win mark.
Consistency is what you're wanting to see out of Joel Stavi from the first quarter all the way through.
On first down at the 18-yard line, it's intercepted and it's a touchdown! Brian Boddy Calhoun with the pick six.
Kevin, Boddy Calhoun, he broke on that ball before the ball was ever thrown. That was fantastic anticipation and really great film study done by him.
His ninth career interception and his third of the year. Ryan Santoso with the extra point to make it 7-0 Minnesota, and Brian Boddy Calhoun on senior day providing an early spark on the defensive side for the Gophers.
Now that just speaks to me about he's watched this a bunch. You're going to see him on the top side. Look at his eyes are back inside, back at the quarterback. He sees it. Look, that ball, he broke on that thing. It wasn't even close. He anticipated it. The quarterback makes a throw. He looks like the intended receiver. Erickson didn't even have a chance to block it. He broke on the ball before it ever happened. That is great anticipation and great job of studying tape to know it. And you think Coach Jerry Kill isn't thrilled about that? You got another thing coming.
We watched him greet all of the players as they came out of the tunnel. Big hugs, big emotion on that Minnesota side. And for Joel Stavi, the emotions and the consistency, those are the things you're looking for Stavi. The consistency is an issue that he's had all year long and all career long.
There's Coach Gill, who really got it together up here and brought this place back into you get ready to play for Minnesota, and Coach Gill's team, you had to be 100% ready. And Tracy Clays has taken that and continued it.
Short kickoff from the 20-yard line, trying to find a little room across the 30, and not much more to be gained there for Wisconsin on the short kickoff. So Strauss can't get much done after that short kickoff, but decent field position now for the Badgers, who've got to try to bounce back from that interception.
And so if you're Joel Stavi right now, what you have to do is forget, this is a whole new game. Forget that play, it's gone, doesn't matter. You spotted him 7 points, let's pick it up from here. Cannot let his emotions rule.
Ogunbowale and Watt behind Stavi. Dario Ogunbowale with the carry. And down near the 37-yard line, tackled by Alex Keith.
And that right there, that's a very positive play. So you pick up yourself 4 yards, 2nd and 6. That's fine. If this Wisconsin run game is getting 4 yards a carry, they're in great shape. What they can't do is get behind the chains like they have been, in particular last week. They just couldn't run the football.
Negative 26 rushing yards as a team last week, and nothing doing here. Ogunbowale met by Shubi Timms, and a loss of 1 back to the 35.
Nicely done by Timms by just reading his keys. And that's what this defense is. It's just good fundamental football, read your keys. They tried to pull in front of him, and he just closed it and followed it right down, took him to the ball, sets up 3rd and long. Showing tight coverage on the top. I like this.
Four-man rush. Stavi to the edge, finds Erickson, who has the first down.
I like that also by Joel Stavi. So you're getting tight man coverage. Boddy Calhoun's on top of your top receiver, which I like that matchup. And so the ball has to be thrown in a tight spot. And guess what? Stavi is right where it has to be. Puts the ball on the money to Erickson. He tried to leverage him. Held the inside. Erickson took that, used it against him, and it's a first down.
11 yards on the play to the 47. Ogunbowale with a hole, and he slips trying to cut back behind Brian Boddy Calhoun. There was a lot of green out there.
That's a big play by the 50-yard line, because if that doesn't get him, he's still running. And they're very aggressive with their strong safety coming down. And he just, right there, that cut, just couldn't quite make it. The 50 got him, but Calhoun, he was going to cut back underneath, and there's nobody behind him.
Second and five as Tywan Deal comes in for the first time at running back. And Deal with the carry, slips one tackle down to the 45. He's 2 yards short of the first, and now third and two with a flag down in the backfield. Stabby still slow to get up.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense number 55. 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. Automatic first down.
De'Aaron Cochran with the personal foul. Joel Stabby was late to get up after that play, and Cochran flagged for 15.
Cochran, one of their better defenders, usually the outside rush guy, has an opportunity to be able to get there. He's got the skills to be able to do that. That one, they went a little too far, apparently.
From the 30, Deal the carry, a little crease, and Deal fighting for extra yardage. Look at the drive from Tywan Deal for the first down. Cody Polk going along for the ride, but this freshman, a guy that Wisconsin's coaching staff thinks very highly of.
Well, he's a freshman, and he has a lot of other freshman friends. They're starting four offensive linemen who are freshmen, along with Deal, who's a powerful kid. I mean, he's got a big upside to him. But it's important and imperative that this offensive line, this group right here, that they get off to a good start and be physical. I said they're starting four freshmen.
From the 18, Ogunba Wale with the carry again, and not much running room this time. Stopped just shy of the 16-yard line. Corey, thank you very much. Our BTN football broadcast presented by U.S. Cellular, with Minnesota leading 7-0. I'm Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington on the field. A chilly day in Minneapolis, and a 7-0 lead as Ogunba Wale, with a good block, breaks a tackle, and is down. First and goal, Wisconsin at the 2-yard line. Kunle Ayinde saves the touchdown for Minnesota.
Ayinde gets Ogunba Wale, but not before Ogunba Wale fouls. A great block by Bo Benshaw inside. Now they've taken Benshaw, one of those freshmen, and they've moved him inside to guard. He's a big bodied guy, and so once you get behind those big body guys, it's hard to see sometimes as a defender, and Ogunba Wale took care of that. Now you got Ingold, another freshman, in right back here, number 45.
First down and goal. The give is to the fullback Derek Watt, fighting for the goal line and stopped just short. He's never had a rushing touchdown in his career. So close there.
Give it to him again. Let him get behind that big offensive line. Let me say this about this offensive line. This is going to be a group that's going to be a terrific group here in the future. Probably next year you'll really start to see it. The year after that is when they will really be a big time group.
Stabby turns, gives to Ingold, and Ingold is in for the touchdown.
Ingold just followed Watt. Watt didn't get the score, but he gave him the score.
6th rushing touchdown this year for Ingold. And an extra point away from tying it up.
But Kevin, more important than that, that offensive line controlled the line of scrimmage that whole series. That's very important for this Wisconsin group.
And the extra point ties this one up at 7 apiece. 8:23 remaining in this very busy first quarter. Already we've seen a pick six in this one from Brian Body Calhoun on the very first play. The interception and the 16-yard touchdown, that delighted former head coach Jerry Kill. And for Wisconsin, they went to the ground. 10 plays, 7 straight runs to punch it in and tie it at 7.
with his sixth rushing touchdown, capping today's U.S. Cellular scoring drive for Wisconsin. It was the ground attack that got it going. 10 plays, 67 yards, 5:04 off the clock. As we go down to Lisa Byington for the first time today, she's standing by with former Minnesota head coach Jerry Kill.
Yeah, an emotional day for Coach Kill. You got to lead the team out. You got to shake the hand of every senior that you recruited here on Senior Day. What have these moments been like for you at being back?
You know what? I'm just living the dream. You know, I'm just, it's been emotional, but we got great kids, and I love those kids, and, you know, I want them to win so bad today for what they've done for the program, what they've done for me.
I'm watching you in the first quarter. You're pacing up and down still like a coach, but you're jumping up and down like a cheerleader. How difficult is it for you to be on this sideline and not be able to coach today?
Well, it's very difficult. I got to stay within this restriction, and I'm not very good at it, but, you know, I get a chance to really analyze the game, and again, you know, I want our team. I'm getting caught up in the action here, but I just want to see our kids do good.
The emotion of this day on Senior Day, but let alone playing a rival and trying to become bowl eligible for the fourth straight year, what kind of accomplishment would that be for this team this year?
It would be tremendous for what they've gone through. There's been so many injuries and so many different things happen to these kids. And for them to, you know, beat Wisconsin, it's the only trophy that they hadn't got, our seniors, and go to a bowl game, they deserve it. They deserve it, what they've been through.
All right, thank you for the time. Enjoy the sideline.
Thank you. I appreciate it very much.
Kevin.
Now, great to see Coach Kill and looking and sounding as good as he does. As Leidner goes to work on first down, his as he throws, looking for K.J. May, and the pass too tall, incomplete. He mentioned those injuries. 24 players, Matt, on the two deep, including 14 starters, have missed time. That's 105 total games lost due to injury for Minnesota this year.
Yeah, that's a bunch, but what it really speaks to is that they have the people behind, and that's the recruiting, and that's the development of players that have been able to step in and make themselves competitive.
So Leidner has gone out wide, and it'll be Brooks who takes the snap. We saw this in the Illinois game, and now Brooks will go to work and not find much room at all. In fact, no gain on the play as Vince Beagle makes the tackle. We'll take a look at today's Auto Owners Insurance Impact Players.
Well, we talked about Shannon Brooks. This kid's got a lot of quickness and big playability, but Schobert and Beagle have been the mainstays of this Wisconsin defense all season long, and they continue to do so.
Two of those three guys making an impact on that last play, with Brooks taking the snap and running the football, and Beagle coming in to make the tackle. T.J. Edwards, another guy who's been playing some good football in that linebacking court.
Yeah, he's really come on. He's developed really nicely. Good job coaching.
Third down and 10. Leidner under some pressure, looking for May, and the pass incomplete. And it's fourth down, and Leidner took some punishment at the end of the play again.
Yeah, two out of the three plays, they were able to get hits on Leidner. And the second one was out of the Wildcats. So they're able to get pressure off the edges. And they're bringing it up inside. You can see Schobert 58 in the middle of that, and Edwards 53 coming from the inside. That's good news for the Badgers, and something that Minnesota's going to have to work on. Hey, Dave Aranda, the defensive coordinator for Wisconsin, is, to me, he's one of the best I've seen. He does a fantastic job each and every week.
Short punt this time for Mortel. Erickson fields and is immediately dropped. Punt coverage has been excellent today for Minnesota. Antonio Johnson in there on the stop after the 33-yard punt. Timeout in Minneapolis. Matt and I on our morning walk on the Stone Arch Bridge earlier today, taking
in the
sights.
I took a swim this morning. I don't know about you.
It was a little chilly for me. It's Dave Aranda.
Hasn't been very chilly for him.
Oh,
Dave Aranda is a fantastic defensive mind. The thinking man's guy. That's Dave Aranda. He's always a joy to meet with.
Wisconsin back to work, and back to work on the ground with Taiwan Deal, and another big hole to pop through, tripped up with a first down, an 11-yard pickup on the play. Let's take a look at today's Auto Owners Insurance Impact Players on this side of the ball.
Alex Erickson's the guy. You saw him in third down. He's the guy they go to. But Cody Polk's a guy, and Jack Flynn. The young players, Polk is the guy. That guy has some outstanding instincts. He's able to get through a lot of the trash and make plays. He's impressive to watch.
At the 38, Deal again. running through a couple of defenders to the 42, a four-yard pickup for the redshirt freshman Taiwan Deal. And Joe Rudolph told us a week or so ago, now that this guy's healthy and he's starting to get a little more confident, he's starting to make a bigger impact, they are really excited about what he can do in the future.
Well, really, they're talking about that whole offensive line. It's a young group. Deal's a young guy. And I know John Settle's there, standing right there with Deal, the running back coach. He has high hopes for Deal and this offensive group.
Ogunbowale, nice little shrug to get free, and a first down to the Minnesota 47. Antonio Johnson with the tackle.
Well, before we go any further, let's talk about Ogunbowale. Because we've been fortunate enough to have been around this team. We got a clear down. But for five games, we've watched them. We've had them early. We've had them in the middle of the season. Now we've had them at the end. I can't think of a guy who has developed more than Dario Ogunbowale. When you watch him at the beginning of the season to the middle to now, the play he made last week was as good a play as I have seen in football, for me, for 40 years that I've been watching football at this level. But Dario Ogunbowale had the wherewithal to be able, when Stave was hurt, to go up and make the snap, get the ball, get it clocked, move on. I mean, that is just a guy who's into the game, and his skill set's good, and he's still developing. I'm very impressed with Ogunbowale.
First down and 10 at the 47-yard line. Ogunbowale with the carry again, and the stutter step bought him some space and got him to the 40-yard line. Eric Murray on the tackle for Minnesota.
We're going to talk about, we said from the start, the team who runs this ball best is going to win the game. And the reason why is this group right here. It's a young offensive line, but they move Ben Shaw down inside to guard right there, number 66. And these guys right now, they're winning the battle. And they are moving people up front, and that's the difference in this football game.
Deal now the carry. And Deal, looks like he's right at the marker at the 37-yard line. Well, one name you're not going to hear carrying the football today is Corey Clement, who's had the injury issues throughout the year. However, this week on Wednesday, he was cited for an altercation that he'd been involved in earlier. And the news came out that the citations were issued on Wednesday. It was announced on Wednesday night that he would not be making the trip. Now, Paul Christ and Wisconsin have not released any official statement, but one can infer that the two are related, the citations and the announcement that he would not be traveling to Minnesota for the final game of the season. As Taiwan Deal, not much running room that time on first down. Polk and Campbell both there to make the stop. And Lisa, you've got a little extra on the Corey Clement story.
Yeah, I actually talked to Paul Christ in the pregame. He said the only thing I can say on the record is the fact that he didn't make the trip. But basically, this coaching staff is going to evaluate the situation. Now, Corey Clement has to prove to them a few things. And there is a potential between now and then that he could still play in a bowl game. But he's got a lot to prove here to this coaching staff and this team from now until then.
On second and 10, Ogunbowale makes two men miss and able to get to the 32-yard line. And like Lisa said, Matt, there was no official statement. Paul Christ isn't saying anything on the record. But in previous games where Corey Clement hasn't played, it was announced Thursday night, Friday morning, that he wasn't going to be making the trip. This one came out the same day as the citation, so I think you can safely infer that the two are related.
Yeah, I would say that's a good bet.
Third and five at the 32.
Keep your eyes on Erickson. He's up here.
So Ogunbowale in motion back into the backfield. Stavi looking, finds Erickson, finds the first down. And Erickson down inside the 20-yard line.
So what makes Alex Erickson so special? Well, it's his ability to get in and out of his breaks. And with the untrained eye, it's one you say, well, heck, he didn't even run a route. Well, that's not the point. It's about feel. It's about understanding. It's about understanding where the defender is, how they're trying to beat, what they're trying to take away from you. He has all that. He reminds me of Steve Largent. I'm telling you, it's Steve Largent reincarnate.
On first down, Ogunbowale hits, fighting forward and down near the 14-yard line. It's a good 5-yard gain by Ogunbowale, but he paid a price for it.
Well, Campbell showed up in a bad attitude point, and that was a heck of a smack that he gave him. But right now, what they're doing, you see Big 66 right there, they are following Bo Benshaw around on a pump. And Ogunbowale gets on his inside hip, and that's a big body with Benshaw, so he's just taking whatever is left in his draft.
Ogunbowale again. He's pretty good at making that first guy miss as he gets 3 to the 11. Eric Murray on the stop. Well, it's what a difference a week makes and what a difference the defense makes. Of course, Northwestern, a terrific defense, but last week, negative 26 yards rushing, already 90 yards rushing in the first quarter for Wisconsin. Talk about recommitting yourself to your strength.
Yeah, and then, they moved Bo Benshaw from tackle to guard. Williams is out. And so now they're just grinding away. And it's that inside group that's winning the battle. Let's see if they don't go back inside. Keep your eyes on Watt, the fullback. He'll take you there.
In fact, he'll take the ball there. Watt all the way down inside the 5 to the 4-yard line. Cody Polk and Duke McGee combine on the stop. But it's first and goal, Wisconsin.
Yeah, again, go back to that offensive line. We'll be talking about that group a bunch because I know how Paul Christ is. If it's working, he's going to make you stop it. He's going to make you prove that it's not going to work. And so Benshaw, 66 on the inside. Maxwell's the one, just a freshman, comes in playing that right side tackle. Then you have Dieter, a freshman on the inside as the center. Kapoy, 75, the left guard, another freshman.
12th play of the drive as Ingold gets the carry, and Ingold is down near the 3-yard line.
Who's another freshman? In all these freshmen, it paints for a very nice picture for the future for Wisconsin offensively. They have traditionally been that team that has a big physical offensive line and always a 1,000-yard rusher. This will be the first year they don't have a 1,000-yard rusher, and I can't remember.
10 straight years they've had one.
Yeah.
And 20 of the last 22.
And so now you have Tywan Deal back in again, number 28. Another freshman.
Deal gets the carry, and Deal upended at the 1-yard line. It'll bring up third and goal now for Wisconsin. We may not see that snap until the second quarter. Watch it one more time. Elbow down before he got to the goal line. Third down and goal.
Linebackers can't get too tight.
And we'll wait and see how this one unfolds at the start of the second quarter, because the first quarter is in the books in Minneapolis. Wisconsin and Minnesota knotted at 7. Wisconsin and Minnesota, the final game of the regular season here on BTN. Wisconsin and Minnesota tied at 7 apiece alongside Matt Millen with Lisa Byington on the field. I'm Kevin Kugler. Badger fans anticipating this game will not be tied for long. They've got a third and goal at the 1-yard line to start off this second quarter.
So, offensive line's got to get off the ball. The defensive line's got to get lower. Low man wins down here. And then that second level, those linebackers can't get too tight.
Tywan Deal with the carry, leaping into the end zone for the touchdown.
They were too tight. It was a wash at the line of scrimmage. And when we come back, I'm going to show you, as a young linebacker, the mistake that Polk makes, number 12. See how tight he is to the line of scrimmage? Because he's tight like that, he can't redirect. And so he steps up and gets caught into the wash, and when he tries to go lateral, he gets hit by the people in front of him. You need to stay as deep as the running back is. You have enough time to get there. That's a young mistake.
Extra point makes it 14-7 Wisconsin, just seconds into this second quarter. And our U.S. Cellular scoring drive, 14 plays, 73 yards for Wisconsin. Of their last 24 plays, 22 have been runs. Let's talk about how to stop some of these runs with Millen's defensive standouts.
Well, there have been some great ones this year. Joey Bosa, of course, had an outstanding year from the beginning all the way through. And then you have Carl Nassib, who leads the nation in sacks. They got a big one coming up. Desmond King has a bunch of interceptions. I think he leads the country. And then his teammate, I like to call him the outlaw, Josie Jewell. He has had a fantastic year, had a big pick yesterday. And up in Michigan, they have a corner. Tell you what, the Lewis kid, he can play. Jordan Lewis has had a fantastic season. Now, I haven't seen all of them play here in the Big Ten, but those guys have really singled themselves out. And that's, you know, not even talking about some of the guys we're watching here today. Like Joe Schobert's had a great year. And Beagle's had a great year. And, you know, we've some guys down in Illinois we watched. And there's a bunch of good players in this conference that had good years. But those are some of the ones that we thought stood out.
And Endicott kick off for Wisconsin. Keontae Harden from the 10-yard line. Harden looking for a little bit of a crease, and Harden down at the 29 as we go to Mike Hall in Chicago for Alexa's studio update.
In Chicago being the key words here, Kev, we check in on Soldier Field, Northwestern Illinois. Warren Long with a 3-yard score. The Wildcats up 14-7, and they just started the second quarter.
Wisconsin behind a strong rushing attack with the 14-7 lead here. 14:51 remaining in the first half. And Minnesota's offense has not been able to get it going. Their touchdown came on a first play pick six from Brian Boddy Calhoun. Look at the ball control. 25 plays to 6. 125 yards to 8. Minnesota still looking for a first down. Leidner trying to provide it through the air as Brooks on the edge lunges forward to the 37-yard line. A pickup of 8 on the play. And it'll bring up second and short.
Interestingly, this was an offense that was in transition. They had not found their running game. And so they had started to transition into being a Leidner passing team. And then he'd run what he had to. And then Brooks starts to show up. And they start to get a little bit more balance. That's what they need. They need balance, but they still need to be able to run the football.
Lingen in motion on second down and 2. The give is to Rodney Smith, and Smith trying to bounce it outside, twisting to the 39, but that's going to be enough for a first down. Jack Sitchy with the tackle. But Rodney Smith, another one of those freshmen, the redshirt freshman running back who's been banged up, gets the first down. Down and 10 at the 39-yard line for the Gophers. Smith hurt his ankle against Ohio State and just now getting back into form. Leidner, short toss, breaking a tackle is Miles Thomas. And Thomas turns a short toss into a big gain to the Wisconsin 38.
Miles Thomas, he's as wide as he is tall. He's a tough guy to tackle. And he has good hands, just sending him out in the flat. Now, you got to make that if you're Michael Caputo. But because of the power of Thomas, he runs right through that and sets up a big first down. Well played.
On first down, Leidner will keep. And Leidner ran right into T.J. Edwards and fought forward to the 33. Tonight, Mello Triple and the Terrapins. They'll take on Cleveland State. Monday, the Hoosiers battle Alcorn State. Coverage starts at 7:30 p.m. Eastern tonight, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN to go. Second down and 7. Good protection. Throws it short. It's Wolitarski, and Wolitarski with a first down to the 16-yard line. 18-yard pickup on the play for the Gophers and a first down.
So they came with a delayed blitz on the inside. Wolitarski. See, Hillary's calling him across. They were playing kind of a zone. Edwards never really felt it. Wolitarski sets down in the hole. That's good eyes by the receiver and picks up a first down.
Now the Gophers on the move, but in the red zone, they've scored a touchdown on just 50% of their trips this year, the second worst percentage in the conference. From the 16, Smith, and a whistle. Before that play had stopped, the officials came running in and stopped it.
Prior to the snap, previous play is under further review.
Tracy plays, wanting to keep the momentum from this drive going, but they're going to take a look at this.
This is a review initiated by the medical observer.
So it comes from upstairs.
It's the medical observer upstairs. Now, remember, after the events of a year or so ago, there's a medical observer in each booth now across the conference, and the medical observer can stop a play when he believes that there is an injured player that needs medical attention. And Caputo is the guy that they are inquiring about.
After medical review, number 7 for Wisconsin must leave the game for one play.
Michael Caputo is a tough kid. He has his hand up and around his chest there, like who knows what it is, but I'm sure by the looks of it, we'll see him again. Now watch number 7. He gets up a little slow.
It's a good job.
It's a good job. If you're not sure, get the timeout. Let him take his play off. It's an outstanding job by the officials, Kevin, I got to tell you.
On first down, Smith stopped just shy of the 10-yard line. So almost the exact same result that Minnesota had on the play with the exact same play that they ran before it was stopped, and Caputo right back into the game.
Yeah, and that's why it's a good job by the officials. If you're not sure, stop it, have him go out, he'll come right back in. Not a big deal.
Second down and 5, motion by Wozniak and now by Lingen. Movement, this is a free play for Leidner. And the fullback Thomas coughs it up, the ball loose on the sideline, he's able to cover it up. But that flag down looked like offsides against the Badgers.
Yeah, it looked like Vince Beagle on the left side. But did you see? There was something that I really liked right there. Michael Caputo. Michael Caputo, remember the last time he went high
offside
on Miles Thomas?
Defense number 47. That 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Yeah, that's Vince Beagle on the left side. And he jumps, he doesn't get back in time, and that's the right call. But what I really liked was the finish of this play. The ball's out in the flat. Now here comes Caputo, inside out. I'm not taking that big guy high anymore. He went right down and took his legs out, and that's well done.
So first and goal for the Gophers at the 6. Remember when they got this football to start this possession, they had not attained a first down yet in the ball game. 4 on this drive as the give goes to Smith. Breaks a tackle, and he's in for the touchdown.
McAvoy had a chance to make that play. He spun out of things and didn't even realize that the back was there. It was a nice cut and a nice run there.
Santoso on to tie it up after the 7-play, 71-yard drive. And what an answer by the Minnesota offense. And we're knotted up at 14 in the battle for Paul Bunyan's axe.
You're a runner, you've got to have great vision. You know where it's supposed to go, and then it pops out the other side. McAvoy can't get there, but Smith does.
Game even the fans need to make sure that they've got helmets on, because it gets physical up in the stands.
It can be. You know, that's the very definition of 10 pounds in a 5-pound set.
Big Ten teams in the college football playoff rankings, 5 in the top 16 this week. Of course, we'll already see some shuffle because Ohio State and Michigan played today. Ohio State, of course, dominating in that one. And then you've got Iowa winning yesterday over Nebraska, keeping their undefeated season intact. Excellent year all the way around for the Big Ten Conference, and it's such an amazing turnaround from where the national perception of was of this league at the beginning, or say a week or two into last season, to where it is now, where you've got a reigning national champion and 5 teams in the top 16.
Yeah, and so I think the big word there is perception, because that's what it was. It was just the perception. It wasn't the reality. And the reality is, look, there are tons of great players in the Big Ten Conference, and they're all over the place. But you can't minimize a team because they're down a little bit. It's not how you start. It's always how you finish. And these teams with these players, they finished strong last year, and they're strong again this year.
On first down, Stavi to throw. Airing it for Erickson. And it's second down as we check in with Mike Hall in Chicago for another Lexus Studio Update.
And Kev, to your point, the lowest-ranked Big Ten team is Northwestern. They're rolling over the Illini early on. Justin Jackson helps make it 21-7 just 20 minutes into the game.
What a start for Northwestern today, building on their win last week up in Madison. Second down and 10.
You need some dental work right there. Okay.
Ogunbowale had a hole. And Ogunbowale fighting for extra yardage down to the 34-yard line. Antonio Johnson, the first guy there, but he needed help from Brian Body Calhoun to bring him down.
Antonio Johnson's been very active. I tell you, he's going to be active again. Ogunbowale just is running hard. And he's a guy who has great balance and always keeps his feet churning. He's the guy who will get that extra little yard and a half, and keep things churning. The more I watch him, the more I like him.
On third down and a yard, Watt again with the carry, and Watt's got the first down. That's already the third carry of the day for Derek Watt. He had one carry on the season coming in. He had one carry a year ago. It's a career day. The final regular season game in the career of Derek Watt.
Don't get too cocky, Derek. Three carries. That's an overload. That's an outstanding player, though. That kid is a tough kid, and he's a big reason why they run the football well.
On first down, Ogunbowale with the carry again, and another good chunk of yardage on first down, nearly 5 for Ogunbowale, as Timms and McGee come up to make the stop. And you said it at the top of the broadcast, Matt, whoever runs the ball best is going to win this game. Well, right now, the ground game is being dominated by Wisconsin.
Yeah, and that young offensive line, which we've talked about. And Dario Ogunbowale is having an outstanding year, game. So is Derek Watt. I mean, it's assignment football right now.
Play action. Stavi. And it's batted away by Brian Body Calhoun. Jordan Frederick, the intended receiver. BTN has you covered all week long as we get you up to speed on all things Big Ten and college sports. Weeknights, 6 Eastern. Join the conversation on BTN Live.
Okay, this is exactly where Minnesota wants Wisconsin. They want him in third and long. Make Stavi beat you. And if I'm Wisconsin, Erickson's the guy. And so you have to be able to defend Erickson.
For 5 on third down. They've got a 3rd and 6 here.
Erickson's up in the top, 1-on-1.
That's where Stavi is looking. Pressure comes, goes short to Ogunbowale. He's not going to get the first down. The pressure threw it off. The tackling by Polk and Murray finished it off, and it's fourth down.
They were looking for Erickson on the top, but what they did, it wasn't 1-on-1. They took their safety and sent him over the top. And see, he's looking right to the top side. He wants to get up top to Erickson, can't do it. Finds Ogunbowale because of the pressure underneath, and Polk is there to seal the deal.
Drew Meyer will punt. Keontae Harden from the 12. Nowhere to go. What a pop laid on him by Natrell Jamerson on special teams. Excellent coverage for both teams in the punt return game today. Timeout on the field. The 42-yard punt. No advance thanks to the play of Jamerson. .752 remaining in this first half. Minnesota and Wisconsin tied at 14 in the battle for Paul Bunyan's axe. And for Minnesota, a bowl berth on the line today as well. And on first down, good first down run by Rodney Smith inside, rather across the 23-yard line. As we take a look at today's United States Marine Corps leader of the game, it's Minnesota's John Christensen. He's got a master's degree in public health administration after getting that regular degree, the bachelor's in biochemistry.
Yeah, just a regular old degree.
Biochemistry.
Yeah.
Eventually would like to become an orthopedic surgeon. Second and three. And Smith wants more. Ooh, good fight by Smith. Look at the effort by Rodney Smith to get the first down.
That's just good news for this Minnesota Gopher team. And it shows you that he's got a little bit of a limp. I was just going to say how healthy he is. Because when he's on, this is what you get. He's got good strength. He knows how to run behind his pads. Keeps his feet going all the time. The combination between he and Brooks is a nice combination, and they'll have it for a few more years here.
From the 31 on first down, Leidner on the keep. And Leidner fumbles the football, and it pops right into the hands of Darius Hillary. It's Wisconsin ball at the 34-yard line.
See if he's down. He has a chance. No, ball's out. Ball is out before he's down. He's got the hand on it.
Joe Schobert
coming out right now, and his knee is not down. That's a proper call by the officials. Joe Schobert gets his hand in there, and the ball's coming out before his knee's ever down. The first one we had was the better look at it. You can see it from the end zone. See how it's starting to come out right now. And, yeah, there you go.
Well, of course, as always, I feel like we say this every time, but it bears repeating, indisputable video evidence, the criteria to overturn. Is there anything that you see in either of those replays that would give you the idea that that play could be overturned?
I would go with the call in the field based off that.
6:32 remaining in this second quarter, tied at 14.
Practice of stripping the ball. And Joe Schobert did it perfectly. And my guess is you read that wrist. It's not a guess. That's what you do. You read the wrist. If the wrist is above the elbow, you strip it.
Nice little spin, and Ogunbowale down to the 29-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Eric Murray on the tackle. PB and Erickson to the top of your screen. On second down, Ogunbowale the carry again with a hole, and Ogunbowale down to the 18 with a first down as we go to my call in Chicago for Alexis Studio Update.
To East Lansing we go, where Gerald Holmes stretches the Spartan lead. And Kev, you know the story here. If Michigan State beats Penn State, they go to Indy next week to play Iowa for the Big Ten Championship.
On first down at the 18-yard line. Ogunbowale again. Just caught from behind as he popped through Alex Keith on the stop. And here's a look at those college football playoff rankings. The bracket, Clemson and Iowa, if it were to end right now, and that would be odd and probably not legal, but Alabama and Oklahoma would play in the other game. The first two out, Michigan State and Notre Dame. But plenty more to happen before we know for sure who's in that playoff.
What's going to be a good game is going to be Iowa against Michigan State. Michigan State's already up on Penn State 13-3, I see.
Taiwan Deal popping in and popping in for the touchdown.
It's just power football, Kev. We mentioned it earlier, but it bears repeating. And again, Bo Benshaw, number 66, with a nice block. And Deal just ran right behind that big offensive line who's winning the battle at the line of scrimmage.
Gaglianone on for the extra point. The turnover leads to the touchdown. Taiwan Deal taking it in for six with this powerful run over the right side. Taiwan Deal happy with the touchdown. The man who caused the fumble, even happier. 21-14, Wisconsin.
And is presented by U.S. Cellular. With U.S. Cellular, now the middle of nowhere is the middle of anywhere. U.S. Cellular.
Yep.
Wisconsin with a 21-14 lead over Minnesota thanks to the touchdown run from Taiwan Deal, giving Wisconsin the touchdown lead once more.
Yeah, I want you to see how they do this. They do this extremely well. It's just tackle down, guard around. It's called a guard. And then you man here. The safety has to run this lane. And so the fullback in front, he has first to show inside. This is run absolutely perfectly. Watch Watt, watch Benshaw. That's, you don't draw it up any better than that. That's really well executed.
P.J. Rozowski on now for the kickoff. Harden from the 5-yard line. Keontae Harden. Had some decent return yardage today. Gets out to the 30-yard line, and Minnesota back to work on offense. Wednesday night, it's an all-new episode of BTN's award-winning original series, The Journey Big Ten Football 2015. It's back on Wednesday, 10:30 Eastern on BTN. Take a look at the similarities between the 1969 Ohio State-Michigan game and this year's contest. Part of The Journey on Wednesday night.
68-69, those were some great years.
Lingan in motion on first down. Smith the carry. And Smith finds nothing. That's because Michael Caputo was there to lead the charge for the Badgers.
Yeah, Michael Caputo is really good down around the line of scrimmage. And yeah, he adapts quickly like you saw in the last. He missed that one tackle and he came back and made sure he didn't miss the second tackle. But he's a guy they like to use and drop him down and create an extra defender in the box. That's all Dave Aranda. That's their defensive coordinator right there. Like I said, that's the thinking man's defensive coordinator.
On second down, Leidner backside pressure hit as he throws it, almost intercepted. Sitchie had it in his hands and he couldn't pull it in. Schobert providing the heat on Leidner and a flag is down.
Schobert's having a big game off the edge here tonight. This one's going to go against those Golden Gophers. Yeah, here's Sitchie right in the middle of your screen, number 48. Yeah, this is a zone drop. His eyeballs are back in at the quarterback. He reads it perfectly. He did everything right, except the difference between a good play and a great play is make the catch. Just a sophomore now. He's gotten a lot more reps with Chris Orr being out. He's responded well. He's got good instincts.
Third down and 10 at the 30. Minnesota 0 for 2 on third down. KJ May, first catch, first down. And KJ May lost the football. Down Darius Hillary able to recover that fumble at the 48-yard line. Second time today that Hillary has had a fumble on consecutive drives for Minnesota.
Yeah, that's tough because Coach Limegrover dials up a really nice play call. And that's KJ May tries to put it. He does put a fake on Caputo. Caputo hits the ball right square in the middle of it, right there. Ball's out. Hillary's on it. Turnover. It's a second time.
And now with 3:55 to go in the half, Wisconsin in Minnesota territory again. Ogunbowale. Tackles missed.
Oh,
another great
nice
cutback. Look at Ogunbowale all the way down to the 33. What a 15-yard run by the Badger running back.
That's an outstanding run. 15 yards, but there's a lot of great cuts in here. Watch the vision. There's the first cut. Boom. Now here comes another one. Right back inside. That is really fun to watch.
Ogunbowale with 105 yards in this first half.
Wow.
Looking to add to it here. And he's down at the 29. Four-yard pickup. Galen Elmore on the stop.
Kevin, you see how decisive he is when he sees the hole. That time he had two blockers out in front of him. When he saw that the cut, that the crease opened up back inside, he just stuck that right foot in the ground, and boom, he goes and hits it right away. That's really some good running. And so for a reward, they take him out and bring in Taiwan Deal.
31 runs today for Wisconsin. Six passes.
Wow.
Second and six. Here's Deal. Taiwan Deal to the edge and using the power to bang his way down to the 24-yard line. Antonio Johnson stops him a yard short of the first.
Antonio Johnson is always active. One of their top tacklers on this team. And I got to tell you, though, you don't want to have your safeties be your leading tacklers. You'd like to have those linebackers in, up in front of them. Because once it gets back to his level, that means there's some yardage involved.
Third down and one. Engel, first down. Now 6 for 7 on third down conversions today. The Badgers are owning the line of scrimmage. That offensive line right now is doing work.
As Dario Ogunbowale is back in, they already have almost 180 yards of rushing. Ogunbowale already over 100 himself.
Ogunbowale breaks one tackle and is down near the 18-yard line. Duke McGee had a shot at him, and Ogunbowale just ran out of the arm tackle, picked up a couple of extra yards.
I can't tell you how big a difference there is in Ogunbowale from the beginning of the season till now. I mean, he has really, John Settle has done a really nice job with Ogunbowale, because you could see the maturation just unfold right in front of your eyes here with him.
Ogunbowale again, got a block down the sideline and into the end zone for six more. Caputo got the turnover, and Ogunbowale cashed it in for six. What a first half on the ground for Wisconsin. And what a block out front by Troy Fumagalli, the tight end, to clear the road for Ogunbowale.
That whole offensive line has just been winning from the very start of the first quarter into this 1 minute and 11 second mark.
And the extra point is good. Dare Ogunbowale, a career high 131 yards, all in the first half. The junior from Milwaukee with great vision, showing some burst, found the hole, and a two-touchdown lead for the Badgers. this first half generated by turnovers. Caputo getting the last turnover for the Badgers, and Wisconsin has really been able to take advantage of the Minnesota miscues.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question. It's the guys who've been, they've been counting on all season long. Caputo, Schobert, those guys are the ones who are forcing the things. And then tell you, Dario Gumbawale has turned in a phenomenal first half here. And then so has that young offensive line.
AJ May at the 15-yard line. And May out to the 27, where Minnesota will start first down and 10. Coming up at halftime, Dave and the gang will get you caught up. It's a busy Big Ten Saturday. Final one of the regular season. The Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report is straight ahead.
Maryland came back and beat Rutgers. They were down early in that game.
By 21.
Yeah, that's a big game.
First down for the Gophers. 1:06 until halftime. They do have all three timeouts. Brooks breaks one tackle. Can't break the tackle of Caputo. And down at the 28-yard line. Remember, Minnesota won the toss and elected to take the football. So Wisconsin's going to get the ball to start the second half with a two-touchdown lead as it stands right now.
Well, it bears repeating. We said this at the start of the game. The team that runs the football best would win this game. And right now, this Wisconsin offensive line has just dominated.
Wisconsin outrushing Minnesota 199-36. Brooks, and Brooks gets a few out near the 33. Jack Cicci.
They're just going to take this in, and that'll be it for the first half.
And Minnesota going to go to the locker room and try to sort some stuff out. Turnovers have played a huge role. The first play of the game was a turnover, a pick six thrown by Joel Stavi to Brian Boddy Calhoun. But two big fumbles down the stretch for Minnesota lead directly to two Badger touchdowns and the difference at halftime.
BTN is brought to you by Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people. Find your agent at autoowners.com.
28-14 Wisconsin with the lead as we get ready to start the third quarter. Kevin Kugler, Matt Millen, Lisa Byington back with you on BTN. We are joined in the booth by a very special guest, former Minnesota head coach Jerry Kill, who got the chance today to run out with the team one final time on senior day. That had to mean an awful lot to you to get the chance to do that.
It did. It meant a whole lot. You know, those kids have been through a lot. And, you know, for me to be there and my wife, who spent a lot of time with those kids, you know, really, that's what coaching's all about.
Well, speaking of coaching, Coach Kill, what you did was set a good, sound, solid base here. And I have, you know, we had a chance to talk a little bit, and I've seen you from afar, I've watched your teams from afar, but what I've seen right away was good fundamental football, and that is the basis of what you taught.
Well, I appreciate it very much. You know, we're struggling a little bit right now up front with some injuries and not, you know, some kids not being able to play. But, you know, the fans, the people have treated us very well, and we had to start, you know, from scratch, so to speak. And we've come a long way, we'll continue to get better.
Coach Kill, tell me a little bit about your epilepsy fund that I know you're investing a lot of time in now.
Well, we have a fund, my wife and I, it's called Chasing Dreams. And what we're doing with that, we have camps. One of them is Camp Oz. And this gives the opportunity to kids that have epilepsy. Some of them have 25 to 30 seizures a day. And it gives us an opportunity to get them in a place with other kids that have epilepsy and do activities and spend time. And, you know, it's something that everybody needs to see to appreciate. And then bringing epilepsy awareness to everybody, because people don't understand that people die from this disease. So just trying to help. You know, I've been on a platform for many years, and you know, when you're on a platform, I really feel like you got to give back. And Rebecca and I are just trying to give back.
Well, Coach, we're gonna keep you here for a little bit because we've got an expert with us in the booth on the Gophers, and while I'm not gonna ask you to what they should do or what they shouldn't do, you certainly know these guys very, very well, and we'll have you hang around with us for a little bit as that one will be downed in the end zone for the touchback. Our U.S. Cellular first half statistics, and you see the rushing yardage for Wisconsin. And we talked about this earlier, Coach Gill. This team has been, your team, former team Minnesota, has been hit by injuries, especially along that defensive line. It's been hard to keep guys healthy up there, and starting to see a little of that wear down today a little bit.
Yeah, we're not very big at the defensive tackles right now. Our 310, 315-pound guys aren't playing, and we're even playing a defensive end in there. So they've been able to move us around pretty good.
First down. Here's Ogunbowale. And Ogunbowale picks up three to the 28-yard line.
So, Coach, you know, a lot of times when you don't have that size, then you end up having to resort to doing some kind of movement and stunts and stuff inside, and that's usually feast or famine, and I think they got caught in a couple of them, especially down on the goal line.
Yeah, you know, like you said, we can't stand in there and just play straight-up defense, so we've rolled the dice a little bit, and again, give them credit. They've taken advantage of it.
Second down and seven for the Badgers. Ogunbowale met by Polk at the 26-yard line. Cody Polk's a guy that we've talked about over the course of the year that's really evolving into a fine linebacker.
Yeah, I like Cody a lot. He's a football player. He's got a lot of natural instincts, and he's going to continue to get better.
Yeah, when you see the things we liked about him a lot, it was he believes what he sees. Not a lot of young linebackers do, and he takes outstanding angles, understands leverage very well. I think that kid Polk's going to be a good player.
Absolutely.
On third down and four, Stavi with some time, and Brian Bobby Calhoun almost had a one-armed interception. Coverage on Alex Erickson, but the Gopher defense does what it needed to do, comes out of the locker room and pitches a three and out.
Yeah, I think, you know, some adjustments. You know, they Wisconsin had a pretty good plan. We're playing those wide defensive ends, and they moved their splits out.
Yep.
and widened that gap. And just from looking up here, it looks like we closed those DNs down a little bit.
Keontae Harden awaiting the Drew Meyer punt. Short punt. Gophers are going to have good field position. It'll be downed at the 41-yard line, and Minnesota starting in excellent shape at the 41 as we check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
Kevin, we are getting destroyed. Those were the words out of Tracy Clay's mouth when he talked about getting beat at the line of scrimmage. And if you saw the fire in his eyes going into halftime, you might understand why Minnesota just had a three and out. I wouldn't want to be those defensive linemen listening to him at the half. In terms of the production of Dario Ogunbowale, I talked to John Settle, his running back coach. He said, hey, the key is, I told him, you are the guy now. Don't look around because there's nobody left. You have to get the job done for us today.
Brooks out of the Wildcat, Lisa, takes the snap and trying to find some running room, but hard to move Joe Schobert off his mark out to the 42-yard line. Jerry Kill is with us in the booth. You were chuckling as you listened to Lisa talk about the fire in the eyes of Tracy Clays. Have you ever seen that fire firsthand when you've looked at Tracy?
You know, the thing about Tracy, sometimes he doesn't say a lot, but when he does, people listen. And, you know, he's a very proud person on the defensive side of the ball. And, you know, to let somebody have 200 yards rushing in the first half, they're going to listen.
Olive Songapolu is down for Wisconsin.
Kevin, you know, you don't ask the guy who put the fire in his eyes if he've ever seen the fire in his eyes. Now, you've been with Tracy for a long time. I know you guys, I know how the coaching world is. And so, you know, there's a lot of good times and there's a lot of good old arguments you get into. So, yeah, I know you've seen the fire and he's seen yours as well.
Absolutely. It's a unique situation. I hired Tracy at Saginaw Valley State for a big sum of $600.
And you told him he was overpaid.
Come a long way.
Yeah.
Second down and nine for the Gophers. First possession for Minnesota in this second half after the Gopher defense forced a three and out. Widener to the air, and a good play by Caputo, who was able to pull it out of the hands of Brandon Lingan. And that's a guy in Michael Caputo that coaches across this league are going to be glad to see leave at the end of this year.
Absolutely, but Wisconsin continues to bring linebackers in. You know, Borland goes out, Caputo comes in, so they've got a tradition of having good linebackers.
And what they've got to do now, this is where they don't want to be, in this third and long right here. This is a situation they didn't want to be in. Now they're going to have to, because what Wisconsin's been able to do so far is generate a pass rush. And here they come again. He's free.
Widener's pass is deflected, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Schobert, and Schobert on the run. A flag is down as Schobert will take it in for the touchdown.
An overload blitz. Coach, you saw it from the top side right away. Nobody picked it up. He came right into his face and looked like the ball was tipped. And it was Cicci who got his hand up. Now, keep in mind, Joe Schobert was a high school running back, and so he's very familiar with bringing it back. We'll see what this flag's all about.
TJ Watt with the tip, and Schobert with the pick. And now the discussion about the flag after Joe Schobert.
Personal foul, targeting, intercepting team number 48. Plays under review.
So Jack Cicci is called for targeting.
Now I want to know if it's after the
correction.
Pick. He just wanted to put his left arm out there. He just wanted to feel good about himself. Yeah, if it's after the pick or before, it has to be after, I'm assuming. The targeting, they'll be going up into the head. It could be with the elbow, could be with the shoulder, or the helmet. All of them count if they're going up towards the head. Now keep your eyes on Leidner, number seven. So that's I don't see any hit up there. Do you, Kevin?
I saw the helmet, and the helmet make contact. His face mask contacts the face mask of Mitch Leidner.
Now here he is afterwards.
Yeah, then this is during the return.
Yeah,
is this what they're looking at?
Different.
That's what they're looking at right there. The hit on Lingan on the return. So not the initial contact with Leidner, but the hit during the return. So post-possession change. They're looking at the hit as Cicci leveled it on Lingan coming back to block.
Well, regardless, the whole thing is fueled by an unblocked defender with an overload blitz to the top side. Cicci is the one who is able to get his hand up and tip that thing, and Coach and Joe Schobert is a guy who's always around the football. He's been doing that for the last couple of years.
Lingan was the guy who got hit by Cicci as he was blocking on the return by Schobert. There's Lingan being tended to by the athletic training staff.
Yeah, so here's Cicci on the top side, and Lingan is right here. Yep, there he is. And that's, you know, you're encouraged to go get a block, go hunt somebody up.
Here's the ruling.
After further review, the ruling of targeting is confirmed. Number 48 for Wisconsin is disqualified. The foul occurred after the interception. The 15-yard penalty reinforced. Wisconsin keeps the ball. First down.
So now, remember this penalty ejected in the second half for targeting. So that will carry over now for Jack Cicci into the first half of the bowl game. Being ejected in the second half of this game.
Yeah.
So the disqualification ends the day for Jack Cicci, and it gives Wisconsin eliminating the touchdown and moves it back to the 49-yard line. Ogunbowale trying to find the edge and is stopped at the 47 by Polk and McGee. pickup of a couple on the play. Minnesota head coach Jerry Kill with us in the booth right now watching this game from above. It's got to be somewhat difficult to watch these guys and not want to jump in there and go, all right, do this, and here's this, and make this happen.
Certainly when you see the blitz coming in. you know, but I think that give credit to Wisconsin. They, you know, it's a different defense, 3-4, and you got to be able to pick those things up.
Stavi to throw on second and 8. And a sliding catch made by Jazz Peavy for the first down at the 37-yard line. We were talking with Coach Limegrover earlier in the week, and he said getting ready for a defense like this is a lot like a defense getting ready for option offense, because it's just so unique to something you don't see very often.
Yeah, you know, all year, you know, we hadn't seen a lot of it, and you know, when you got a freshman center and a nose over him, it's a different deal.
Oh, completely different.
Taiwan Deal. Cody Pope fighting through that block to make initial contact, and then Eric Murray was there to finish him off.
So, Coach, the one thing that's interesting, so they changed the alignment a little bit defensively with their tackles. And so the old rule was if they tried to gap you out of things, if you could take it, you better make it.
Yeah.
And so that was the rule we kind of always went by, and I'm sure it's the same thing there.
Same rule.
Yeah.
Same rule.
Second and 7. Ogunbowale able to find a little bit of room and then tripped up at the 30 by Jack Lynn.
Sits this third in manageable, and this is an area where a lot of things come into play. So the feet of the cornerback, you have to be able to defend. They've been already dominating the line of scrimmage, and so you have to defend edges plus inside.
Third and 3 at the 30. Stavi on the roll, throws on the run. Nice pitch and catch with Alex Erickson to get the first down. Antonio Johnson nudging him out at the 26.
Coach, that play right there is what I'm talking about. So now you start to use the quarterback's feet so you can get him on the edge, and that gives you a little bit of room to be able to see. But the receiver, that Erickson kid, gets in and out of his breaks so well. So if you try to leverage him, he just takes advantage of it and takes what you give him. And if the ball's there, it's hard to defend.
There's no question about that.
At the 25, first down, Ogunbowale. Oh, what a hit. Leveled Devondre Campbell just flying in there, and Devondre Campbell providing a little pop.
The nice read, and then when you have an opportunity, run through it. Absolutely stick your face right in the middle like he did. He came unabated, make the play.
Second down and 10 at the 25. Ogunbowale again in some trouble, trying to slip away, but for the second straight play, Devondre Campbell is there. The initial penetration by Hendrick Ekpe threw that whole play off, and Minnesota's defense stiffening here. It's third and long.
This is where they want them again right now, Coach. You get them in the third and long, you can kind of dictate things to them.
Absolutely. You know, on first down and second down, with stopping a run, we've had to be able to get 9 in the box.
Right.
And that's why they can complete the out. But if you get them stopped on first and second here, you can dictate them throwing the ball and getting your nickel coverage.
So now third and 13. Stavi looking for Erickson, can't get it to him, and it's fourth down.
Good defense. And so you're able, they still went 2 man under and a cover 2 over the top. So you're going to be able to protect yourself for anything deep down the field. But there was nothing there. Look, I hope he threw that away. If not, that was a really bad throw.
Well, there's no doubt about it. You know, you get somebody, you know, in third and long, you can do a lot of things on defense. Looks like they're going to go here.
Kind of a no man's land at the 28-yard line, but fourth and 13.
Which tells you that he trusts his defense. He likes what his defense has been doing here. What are you going to gain with a kick? So they're going to try it.
Play clock is winding down. It's down to one and down to zero. But first, the timeout is taken by the Wisconsin Badgers. Jerry Kill, thank you so much for coming up with us. That was a real treat for us. We wish you the best of luck moving forward.
I appreciate it very much.
Coach, enjoyed it very much. Look forward to seeing you again.
Absolutely. Take care, guys. Appreciate it.
Jerry Kill, some big moments in this one. Now Coach is going to get back to the cheerleader role, chasing dreams and chasing a bowl. The Gophers down two touchdowns. 28-14, Wisconsin with the two-touchdown lead in the battle for Paul Bunyan's axe, and after the timeout, a change of heart. Rafael Gaglianone on for the 46-yard field goal try. Good snap, good hold, and the kick is good. Gaglianone puts three on the board, and Wisconsin's lead grows to 31-14. Paul Crist changing his mind and going with the kicker. And his sophomore kicker delivers from 46 yards out. Plenty of distance. Plenty of accuracy. Yeah, he's fired up. Why not? His team's up 17. Series that is in its 125th all-time meeting, the 68th, with the axe on the line.
You know, that Paul Bunyan drug, when he dragged that axe, that's how the Mississippi was formed. You know that, don't you?
Thank you, Cliff. From the 10 and out of bounds as we check in with Mike Hall in Chicago for the Lexus Studio update.
Kevin, you and Matt are going to want to watch this catch. Connor Cook to Aaron Burbridge. He makes the grab, spins not once but twice away from defenders, and dives in for the end zone. Spartans are up by 17 points.
Unbelievable.
Phenomenal. He's had that kind of year, too. Burbridge had a great year for Michigan State.
To the 12-yard line after the kickoff return went awry for Minnesota. And Shannon Brooks in the backfield next to Leitner on first down. Leitner going to scramble. And Leitner, a little head and shoulder fake, gets out of bounds at the 17-yard line, a 5-yard scramble.
Well, he's healthy. He was in a boot at the beginning of the week. I mean, you can see that he has his mobility. So if he's going to, if they're going to do anything here, Leitner's feet are going to have to become a part of that happening, because when you start taking off and running, they have to commit somebody else into that mix. Right now, they're loading the box, taking away this run, and they've been bringing blitzes to them.
On second and five. Oh, my goodness. Almost intercepted by Connor Sheehy. They were setting up the middle screen, and Sheehy nearly had a pick six.
And in the film room, they'll say, that's why you're a defensive lineman. Sheehy reads it right. Oh, he just got one hand on it. That was going to go back underneath to Brooks. So he'll get a pass defense.
Yes. But he's still frustrated as he gets over to the sidelines. That's for a defensive lineman.
It's close.
That's a close call.
Oh, yeah. His feet may have to bail him out of this. And they're using him.
Rolls out too tall, looking for Nick Hart, his tight end, at his fourth down.
Yeah, and that's on Leitner. He knows it. And that's got to be a better throw to him. And I like the play call. Coach Limegrove, the offensive coordinator, does a nice job of moving him because they've been getting pressure inside, so they're taking him out of the pocket. Now it's incumbent upon the quarterback to be accurate with that throw, and he missed it.
So Mortel will punt away. Alex Erickson is back at the Badger 40-yard line. Erickson backs up, calls fair catch, and makes it at the 32-yard line. Timeout on the field with 7:43 remaining in the third. 17-point lead for Wisconsin. Saturday's football championship game on game day. We get you started at 6:30 Eastern with the championship pregame. Stay with us at the end of the game. We're live with interviews, reactions, and more next Saturday, live from Indianapolis on BTN. And don't forget the Big Ten championship game you can find on Fox. Hard to believe we have reached the end of the road for the regular season in 2015.
Went fast, but they always do.
Now the Badgers back to work with a 31-14 lead. And the flip to Erickson trying to get to the corner. Nice little hesitation that bought him the time he needed to get around the tackler in the backfield and gain positive yardage. 5 yard pickup. McGee was the guy he slipped around in the backfield and picks up five.
So now if you look at this, the second half as opposed to the first half, you're seeing more runs to the outside. In the first half, you heard Coach Kill talk about it. They were playing their hands a little bit wider and spreading them out. And so Wisconsin did a nice job of running inside. Now they've tightened those things down. And so now they're trying to get to the edge.
Movement. That's the right guard. Moving just a little bit early.
False start. Offense number 66. 5 yard penalty remains. Second down.
I will say this, though, other than that mistake from Bo Benshall, what a start he's had today, moving from right tackle to right guard with the retooled offensive line. It's like he was a guard in a tackle's uniform the last six starts.
And he had a rough one last week against Dean Lowry. Dean Lowry's a heck of a football player. We're playing in the National Football League. Just a freshman, Benshall. He's going to be an outstanding player.
He's playing really well today. On second down and 11, going right that direction is Ogunbowale, and he gets back that penalty yardage to the 36-yard line. So it's third down.
And so now this goes on to Staubbe. In the last few third downs, he's not thrown the ball well. I mean, this running game has really been the mainstay and has carried the day. Staubbe has got to make a couple throws here.
With protection, Staubbe fires. Erickson with the catch, and Erickson gets away from Bonnie Calhoun. Erickson all the way down inside the Minnesota 40 before Antonio Johnson can catch up.
Yeah, but let's give credit where credit is due. That was a great throw. He had nice protection. He was able to stand in a pocket, but the ball was thrown away from Calhoun, like you said, and Erickson just leveraged him. And the ball was where it had to be on time. Well done. Good execution.
18th Wisconsin first down today. To five for Minnesota. Ogunbowale able to get a couple down near the 36-yard line as we check in with Lisa Byington.
Well, Joel Staubbe told me in the pregame one of the ways that Paul Christ has helped him is to be able to trust his teammates. And obviously there's a real special connection between Joel Staubbe and Alex Erickson as well. But that's one thing that Paul Christ has taught him this year. You trust your teammates, and that way it takes the pressure out of getting out of this outside of your own head and feeling the pressure that you have to carry this team individually. He leans on Alex Erickson for a lot of confidence and trust him solely.
That's a good guy to lean on, and Erickson has been extremely dependable.
To the 35 goes Deal. Campbell on the stop. Ogunbowale today, 27 carries for 147 yards, continuing to build on his career high as he makes his way back on the field for third down.
Yeah, and so Ogunbowale's had a nice day here. Deal's had a nice day here as well, which tells you that the offensive line's had a big day. And so now comes protection time. And so if you're Minnesota, you have to find a way to get off the field right now. Last time they played him in the zone, let's see if they do the same.
Third and 7. Staubbe strikes and a first down. And not a surprise, when you need a first down, where do you go? You go to Alex Erickson.
Yeah, that time they were in man coverage. And so you draw Erickson, you better stay on him. So they give him a cushion. Now he just, his eyes beat him. Bonnie Calhoun, did you see his eyes went back inside to the quarterback? When that happens, he's dead. When you're in man, see the man. You have to be able to keep your eyes on the guy you're defending the whole time. The minute you take him off, that's what happens.
Taiwan Deal. down at the 25 after a gain of two.
Taiwan Deal, the more he plays, the more he'll learn to get his pad level down. Ogumba Wally's done that from the beginning of the season to now. Deal has good power. Deal has an ability to accelerate. He'll be even better when he gets his pad level down and can accelerate with the top of his pads instead of his chest. The chest is a nice area to hit. Top of your pads, it's a lot.
Here he goes again and leaning in for a yard to the 24-yard line. So now third and seven. The last two third-down conversions have both been passes from Stavi to Erickson. That last pass by Stavi that converted on third down was his 1,000th career pass attempt. He's second all-time in Wisconsin history. Darryl Bevel had 1,052 attempts in his career. When the career of Joel Stavi is done, his name's going to be all over the top of the Wisconsin record book.
Erickson's in the slot, man-to-man, with a safety sitting over the top.
On third and eight, Stavi, the pass is caught, but short of the first down. Jordan Frederick makes the catch, but does not get the yardage needed for the first, and Aglianoni will come on for a field goal try. Will be from 40, hit from 46 early. And he's now two for two, but a flag is down.
Now, if that goes against Minnesota,
offense number 91, 10-yard penalty, three fourth down.
That's going to move him back.
And that takes a 40-yard field goal off the board and would mean a 50-yard try if Paul Christ elects to try from that distance.
91's right here, the closest guy to you. Yeah, and that's, yeah, I played that position for 13 years. Let me say, so that's not the way you do it. Okay? You always take the inside man, use his momentum to push you back outside. You don't stand there and spread your arms out.
So now from 50, this would be a season long. Trying to curve it back, and this one, no good. So the penalty costs the Badgers 3 points, and the score stays 31-14. Minnesota ball when we return. Holding penalty costs Wisconsin a field goal. They took it off the board, tried from 50, and could not convert. So Goldie hoping that the Gophers can figure out a way to rally here, down 31-14. A bowl bid on the line for Minnesota. If they win, they're bowl eligible. If not, well, 5-7 may not get it done. Leidner airing it deep for KJ May, and it's batted away by Tanner McAvoy. Ball looked like it was headed out of bounds anyway, but just to be sure, McAvoy came over and swatted it out of bounds.
Yeah, and so they tried a little double move, but it was against the cover too. And you saw Caputo on top of it, but McAvoy, he tracked it right from the start. So he got on his horse and ran that thing down, and it didn't have a chance. That's up to second and long. Both these safeties have played well here today, Caputo and McAvoy.
On the keep, he's in trouble, and down he goes. Vince Beagle didn't buy the fake, throws him for a 1 yard loss.
I think Vince Beagle is going to be a good pro. I think he gives you great versatility, and I think that's what Dave Aranda, the defensive coordinator, is the guy that he counts on, this guy right here, Vince Beagle, a lot. As Vince Beagle can play outside linebacker like you see here. See how well he played that? He can put his hand down, can go from a 3-4 to a 4-3. They go under, over, they go a lot of fronts, and all because of the versatility of Vince Beagle.
Third and 11. Good protection for Leidner. Throws, and short of the first down. Stacked up at the 40-yard line is Nick Hart. Tackle made by Chris Orr. Good to see him back out there. Yeah. We were told he might play some today after battling that left leg infection. And great to see the freshman from DeSoto, Texas, back on the field for the Badgers. Yeah, and he came in when Jack Cicci was ejected for targeting.
Right. I played with his dad. He comes from a good football line. He's going to, this whole group is going to have to be on right now because it's fourth and they're going for it.
Fourth and two at the 40. Play clock is at two. Play clock is at one. And I don't think there was a timeout called, or was there on the sideline?
Should be from the sideline.
Play game.
Oh, jeez.
Offense. 5-yard penalty remains fourth down.
And maybe they just weren't going to run it, so they were just going to try to get them off sides, or if not, let it run down. That's probably what they were going to do.
Well, you're not
going to
burn a timeout in that situation. You want to save those in case you can start to chip away at this one. So Mortel will punt. And there's Alex Erickson once more awaiting the punt.
Wisconsin punt team. Wasn't sure about that.
Final play of the quarter here. As Erickson clears everybody away and watches that one go out of bounds near the 15-yard line. We've reached the end of the third quarter. Fourth quarter coming. The battle for the X with 15 minutes left. BTN football in the regular season. Wisconsin and Minnesota closing it out, and so far Wisconsin's been dominating the line of scrimmage and dominating in the ball game with a 31-14 lead. Not much scoring in this second half, but time of possession sometimes doesn't tell the tale, Matt Millen, but today it kind of does. Wisconsin's had the ball for over 31 minutes. Minnesota's had it for just 13 minutes and 51 seconds in this game.
Give Minnesota's defensive front credit here in the second half. They have taken that 200 yards of rushing in the first half, not as much here in the second half. So they've shut that down a little bit.
On first down, Taiwan Deal backs his way forward to the 20 as we go back to Chicago. Mike Hall's got another Lexus studio update.
Kevin, Connor Cook has played all game. He's looked very good, and the Spartans look good. Josiah Price from 6 yards out, and the Spartans have the lead at this point, 34-10. Just a little more than 15 minutes to go, and they're playing Iowa and Indy.
Yes, they are. They're playing Iowa and Indy. You can say that again, Mike. That Penn State doesn't have the ability to come back with stuff like that.
On second down, Deal showing a little shiftiness, and he gets the first down. So essentially, when you look at that college football playoff bracket and the rankings that we showed earlier, this Iowa-Michigan State game looks like a playoff game in and of itself, playoff for the playoffs.
It really is. And I think that's what the championship games are designed to do, and to get into the playoff rankings here. Iowa's had a fantastic year. They're undefeated. That'll be a good game. That's it. That's going to be a great game, as a matter of fact.
There's no guarantees in life, but it would seem pretty obvious the Big Ten's going to be a part of that playoff this year with either the Spartans or the Hawkeyes, as that one is taken by Deal to the 32-yard line. Like I said, no guarantees. Strange things can happen when you're putting rankings together, but it seems like right now the Big Ten's in awfully good shape to be represented once more in the playoffs.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about that. And I think whoever wins that Big Ten championship game will be one of those Final Four.
Second and eight. Oh, what a hit. Nick Rawless with the biggest hit of the day.
He beat Diener's block and just came. That's called coming downhill. You come downhill like that, there's usually a nice stick on the end of it, and he had a nice stick.
Third down and nine. Pressure coming. Stavi over the middle and a sliding catch by Erickson. Nope, incomplete. Couldn't hang on as he made the slide, but a flag is down. It's on the far side of the field.
You know, they came with a slot blitz. And the ball was thrown behind because Erickson was wide open. He still should have made that catch.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense. Number 86 was covered up and went downfield. That penalty's declined. Result of the play is fourth down.
So Meyer will punt it away for Wisconsin. Deontay Harden awaiting the punt.
Nice punt.
Takes a nice roll, too. Harden scoops it up, and he is stopped immediately because you cannot advance it at that point after he waved it off. An invalid fair catch. Wisconsin fans saw that last week with Alex Erickson. They stopped it immediately here.
Which they should. Any waving motion. Any waving motion. Oh, yeah, that's... Any waving motion is going to be an invalid fair catch. I know that rule now, let me tell you. Got it!
Not sure that windmill motion is recommended by most orthopedic surgeons.
But it looks good on him.
And it looks good as they'll play in the Big Ten Championship if they can hang on against Penn State to face off against Iowa. Here 31-14 as Minnesota goes back to work, and it's dropped at the 30-yard line. Leidner with a pretty good throw, and he had Wolitarski over the middle, just couldn't pull it in.
They have not been able to get on track all game long. That run game has accounted for just 47 yards. And then you have to have something that's going to generate it. You think you'd be able to at least develop some kind of a pass game. They haven't been able to do that as well. Well, you have about 130 yards of total offense here through three and, you know, a couple minutes of quarters.
Second down and 10. KJ May with the grab. And May down at the 25. Just his second catch of the day as we check in with Mike Hall in Chicago. Alexis studio update.
Kevin, update on the land of Lincoln. The offense not doing much for the Illini, but the defense is. Tipped ball to Mason Monheim, and he's running on that Soldier Field grass. 57 yards for the score, so we start the fourth quarter. Northwestern only up by 7. Kev?
Wow.
That Illinois defense has been playing well all year. They don't have enough bullets in the gun offensively. But defensively, they've got some good players.
Bill Cubitt today, it was announced, will be the head coach, signing a 2-year deal with Illinois. Leidner on the roll on third and short, and it's incomplete. At the 35-yard line, looking for Rashad Still, and it's fourth and 2.
Well, he went to Still. KJ May is the guy they were trying to get to. And Wisconsin did a great job of fighting through the pick or the rub to be able to take that away. Yeah, and it's right. It's Hillary. Watch Hillary. See how nice a job. He clears the top. That takes him away from KJ May, and he has to go deep, and it sets up a fourth down. That's well played by Hillary.
A big reason why Minnesota is trailing in this game, Matt, is their inability to convert on third down. They're 0 for 7 now on third down today as Erickson fields at the 30-yard line. Trying to dance free. Erickson. And he'll duck out of bounds after a 10-yard return at the 40-yard line. 11:19 to go. Wisconsin ball. Good to have you with us from the Twin Cities tonight alongside Matt Millen with Lisa Byington on the field. I'm Kevin Kugler. A 31-14 lead for Wisconsin in the final game of the regular season for these two teams. Minnesota trying to rally and earn a bowl berth. Wisconsin trying to further stake their claim for a very nice destination this holiday season. And on first down, Ogunbowale with the carry. And Ogunbowale picks up a couple as we take a look at today's Dr. Pepper play of the game.
Well, it's Dario Ogunbowale, number 23, and it's his touchdown. He had a lot of A lot of help from that offensive line, but let me tell you, he's had himself a great game here today. Whether it's been protecting in the pass game or running the ball, he's been money.
That's today's one-of-a-kind Dr. Pepper play of the game. He's got the most rushing yardage by a Wisconsin player this season, Matt. 29 carries for 150 yards. And his 30th carry of the game takes him from the 44 near the 47-yard line, tackled by Nick Rawlis. Now, the second half has been less productive. Remember, Ogunbowale had 131 yards on 19 carries at halftime.
And the little bit of adjustment that this Minnesota defense has done, playing their guys a little bit more to the inside, has tried to force this running game to go outside, although they've tried to stay back inside like you've seen. Sets up this third and manageable. Let's see if they so keep your eyes again on Erickson, who's down here.
Third down and four. Stavi on the roll, in some trouble, and just throws that one away.
That's a smart decision by Stavi. It was good coverage on Erickson because that's exactly where they wanted to be able to go. They got pressure. Johnson up in his face, so he just threw it away. But Erickson was just going to run that little out route, try to leverage the defender. But the coverage was really good.
Keyonte Hardin waiting for the punt from Drew Meyer. We broke down earlier Matt's defensive standouts in the Big Ten. That was easy for him as this punt goes into the end zone. What's hard to do is to get a defensive guy to give anybody on offense credit.
Yeah, but it's not hard for C.J. Beathard. C.J. Beathard has had a phenomenal year, as had Ezekiel Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott complained about not getting the ball enough. Well, they gave it to him today, and he got over 200 yards rushing. Aaron Burbridge, as you witnessed a little earlier, still making big plays. And Nate Sudfeld from Indiana has had a huge year throwing the football. Not to be outdone, Alex Erickson, when they need something, he's come through for them all season long. Just a few of those guys, and there's more out there, but I'll tell you, some of those guys there had just fantastic years.
Five of Erickson's six catches today have been on third down. He's been the go-to guy on third. They throw it back to Brooks, and Brooks trying to find some running room, and he found some. Brooks up the sideline into Badger territory, and a terrific play by Minnesota. Christensen providing the block on the edge, and Brooks doing the rest of the work, picking up 33.
That's a nice call by Coach Limegrover, the offensive coordinator. You see how he just kind of saunters out there to the left, and then him in the open field. And there's two freshman running backs in the Big Ten that I watched this year that are impressive, and he's one of them. And Saquon Barkley out of Penn State. That kid's really talented.
38 yards on that game. And Leidner on the run. Oh. And it's almost intercepted. McAvoy had it, and he just couldn't pull it in.
Yeah, and keep in mind, they use McAvoy as a receiver. He's got good receiving skills. He's going to be mad at himself because that's one he should still be running. You're going to see him in the upper right-hand corner right here. And what's going to bring him to the ball is his eyes. See, he's eyeballing the quarterback the whole time. Now here comes the defender, undercut it. He should still be running. He's got good speed. He's got good hands. And he dropped it.
Had two of those four interceptions against Maryland. As Leidner hit as he throws, airing it. And there, McAvoy gets a second chance, and this time he pulls it in. Oh, the pressure coming from T.J. Watt, and McAvoy with a second opportunity, able to pull it in, and Leidner hurt after the hit.
T.J. Watt, number 42, is a lot like Vince Beagle. They're very similar, and he's got that ability to be able to create pressure, and here it is. There's the pressure, and here's the throw. Looks like McAvoy was the intended receiver, and there's the pick.
Wisconsin 31, Minnesota 14. The Badgers trying to keep the axe for a 12th straight year. And on first down at the 30-yard line, Stavi, Taiwan Deal, and a pickup of 6. And it's second down. And this run game for Wisconsin today has just dominated the injury-depleted Golden Gophers. Inside that box is where the Axe has spent its afternoon. Of course, we've seen some great moments over the years in this battle for Paul Bunyan's Axe. You remember 2 years ago, Wisconsin went to chop down the opposing goalpost, and all the Minnesota players and security folks formed a barrier in front of the goalpost to keep them from chopping it down. Second and 4. A little hesitation, and then down at the 38 is Deal in the arms of Nick Rollis and Alex Keith. Third down and 2. Yardage. Nick Rollis again has been making some big plays for this Gopher defense in the second half.
Yeah, nice job of reading that bullet and getting in, because they had the edge. They were going to be able to get it, but Rollis didn't allow it. He came from the inside out by shooting that gap up inside.
Towards the sideline and out at the 28-yard line. Our final game of the season, and thank yous to a tremendous crew that we've been with for the last couple of years. Our producer, Bart Fox, our director, Tom Hewitt, technical managers, Brett Smith, our technical director is Andrew Blaustein, tape producer, Tony DeSanti, associate producer, Denny Blunt, our graphics man, Jordan Reese, computer stats, Dave Frambees, a lot of people here. Greg Malinowski and Sean Quashney handle the audio. Mark Hall and Karen Kvitek, our EVS folks, our stage manager and spotters, Mike Bazemore, our talent stats, Kevin Messenger, Terry Lamy, John Pigeon, Tony Medici, all in charge of the cameras, Steve Sontag, Mark Wallerman, Ryan Meese, Steve Dixon, our mobile unit engineers, as Leidner goes to work on first down and heads to the sidelines. A few others we need to thank for making sure we get on the air every week, our unit operator, John Perillo, Mark Halsey, the senior VP of production and the executive producer, senior coordinating producer Bob Lanning, our coordinating producer Alex Birchie, the manager of remote operations John Sugihara, Catherine Swanson's the manager of graphics operations, and Brian Kelly, our researcher for remote production. A thank you to all. It's a great crew. We've been with them all year long, everywhere we go. Tremendous folks, and it makes it fun to hang out on the road each week. On second down, Leidner, a little bit low and pulled in by Rashad Still. Nice catch by Still at the 36-yard line.
And a nice throw by Leidner, because he came and had a blitzer right in his face, and he delivered that thing.
Well, he's a tough kid. Make sure he pulled that one in, and he did. Leidner, pressure again, and he's able to get rid of it, and he finds his tight end, Nick Hart. McAvoy finally able to catch up to Hart at the 34-yard line of the Badgers.
This is some great hands. That's the coverage was there by Caputo. Hart just hang on that thing with his fingertips.
Leidner to KJ May, makes a sliding grab at the 27 as we check in with Lisa Byington.
Well, Mitch Leidner is moving his team down really on two injured legs. He had the walking boot on his left leg. He's got a healthy limp on the right side, but that's one of the reasons why he is so respected on this team. He's one of the toughest on the team. You see one of the best players take a hit and hop up, it's motivating.
And Drew Olatarski able to break free, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown. This one's not over.
job by the offensive line to be able to give him some time to be able to throw, while Tarski just sat down in the zone and he beat Sojourner Shelton to the end zone.
Santoso good on the extra point, and a 10-point lead for Wisconsin as Drew Wolitarski, his third touchdown catch of the year.
Yeah, I mean, nothing complicated. Just sat down. There's nothing out there, but because Leidner had time to be able to throw from his offensive line, Wolitarski's able to make that catch and stick it in the end zone.
Gophers have scored 14 of those 21 on offense. The first seven of the day came on the pick six by Brian Boddy Calhoun on the very first play from scrimmage.
Two-score game with 5.5. See if they would this be a chance, a time here to take a chance. They're going to need to get the ball at least two times here.
Don't forget tonight, Mello Trimble and the Terrapins take on Cleveland State. On Monday, the Hoosiers battle Alcorn State. Coverage starts 7:30 p.m. Eastern tonight, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN2Go. Great time of year, football, basketball, everything going on. Wrapping up the regular season today in the Twin Cities. And Minnesota in the final 5:33 needs 10 points to keep this one going and keep their season going. Trying to win it and wrap up a bowl berth.
And Wisconsin's thinking the same way we are.
0-for-3 on onside kicks this year. Hart with the onside try. Got the big hop and it goes out of bounds.
Never went 10 yards. So it'll go out of bounds right there. They'll throw the flag.
Got the hop they were looking for, just not the distance.
See if they if the kicking team tried to touch it or did touch it before it went 10 yards.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team. The ball will be placed 5 yards from the spot where the ball went out of bounds. First down, Wisconsin.
So he didn't touch it, but it didn't go the required 10. It went out of bounds, so they will take it from there. Paul Christ has had himself, I think, for his first year back in here, an outstanding year. And slowly but surely, this team has come around, and the good news for this team is they're awful young. This will be a much physically stronger team next year than you're seeing right now. I think that's the biggest thing that he noticed when he came back, was that they weren't as physically developed as a group as when he had been here previous. And so I think he'll get that this offseason. He'll take care of that side. They'll get in a weight room. They'll get that offensive line big and more physical. And you'll see an improved run game, one that's produced over 250 yards of rushing here today.
On second down and 7 at the 34. Ogunbowale again, and Ogunbowale slips down at the 33, and now Minnesota uses one of its three timeouts. They elected not to use one after the first down run. They used their first here, leaving them with two timeouts and 4:46 remaining as Wisconsin has 3rd and 6.
Yeah, so they've got to be able to get the ball back, but they have to keep time on that clock. And keep in mind, once they have the ball offensively, just by getting the first downs, you can stop that clock and slow it down. But from this side right here, they've got to be able to get off without giving that first down up and get the clock stopped.
Let's take a look at today's Duluth Trading hardest working player. It's Joe Schobert. 5 tackles, the interception, the forced fumble. Schobert has had not only a strong day, but he's had an excellent season.
There's Joe. He's had a... Yeah, and keep in mind, they took the interception touchdown away from him. He's had a great year. He really has. I mean, he's the kind of guy, he's a coach's dream. You tell him to do whatever you want him to do, he gets it done. Very disciplined, very skilled. You'll see him in the stadium on Sundays next year.
Third and six. Stavi over the middle looking for Erickson, and he couldn't connect.
And that's exactly what Minnesota needed. They stopped the clock. You get the fourth down. You get the ball back. You've saved time. This way, you're only at 440. They still have two timeouts in their back pocket. This went well.
Had they used the one timeout on the first down play, it'd be at about 5 minutes and 10 seconds, but you'd only have one timeout. Do you trade those 40 or so, 30 or so seconds for a timeout?
Yeah, I would have. I think they managed that pretty well right there.
Meyer trying to pin the Gophers deep.
Delay a game.
I would decline
offense.
This.
That penalty is declined. It remains fourth down.
Yeah, that's an advantage when you take, so you delay a game so you can move back a little bit. And it helps you with your angle when you're kicking, or not as. I would decline that penalty, which is smart. They did. You don't want to let that. You don't want to help them.
Four straight punts for Wisconsin. That's Meyer. Turn this one over inside the 10. Oh, great play. Did they keep it out of the end zone? What a dive by Natrell Jamerson. And now they're going to say touchback. He did not keep it out of the end zone. What an effort, though, by Jamerson.
Great effort. Remember, it's where, in college, it's where the ball is. The player can be beyond the end, into the end zone, but if the ball doesn't go, it still stays. But if the ball goes over that end zone, end line, then they'll bring it back. Now, there would be a line. There should be an official right over here to the top of your screen whose job it is to watch that.
It must have just snuck across that line right about there.
Yeah, see the official sitting right here? His eyeballs were right on it. He's standing right on the line looking straight down it. That's his job to see it.
The ruling on the field was a touchback. The play is under further review.
An indisputable video evidence based on what we have seen so far is going to be almost impossible to do anything that overturns the ruling on the field. One more look at this.
Yeah, and so that, you know, it's close from there. But the other angle where you saw that the official was standing on the goal line looking straight down, and that's what you would, you know, he had the best view right there. See the official standing right up here. And his eyes, he's looking that thing right down the line. He's got the best view in the house. And he threw his beanbag there.
Well, the angle of our cameras, Matt, are not such that it's going to provide conclusive evidence to overturn this. And I don't think you're going to see any change in this one at all.
No, I don't think so. Plus, you're going to trust, I mean, he's right on the line.
And it stands. It'll stay at the 20-yard line. That's good work by that officiating crew. Check that one out. Made sure they got it right. And again, those angles, it's just impossible to tell. And you're not going to overrule the guy who's right there on the goal line with the best view at that.
So now is, look, the game, this is still a two-score game right here. All Leonard has to do is just do the same thing he did this last series. Get right down the field, pick them apart.
Leidner looking deep down the right sideline. The diving attempt and just off the KJ May fingertips at the midfield stripe.
Nicely done by Caputo, and Hillary are right there. Hillary has a man for man, but Caputo makes up a lot of ground as a safety. That's some good range. Good job by Hillary of staying with that. cover the blitz.
Picked up May with the catch, and Leidner got rid of that quickly. T.J. Edwards on the stop at the 24-yard line. Pretty good work by Leidner in the face of that pressure.
Yeah, he's seeing the free guy coming. Now the ball, the clock is moving. He's got to get this thing off. There's more pressure.
May on the sideline, first down.
Great job by Leidner. Great vision, saw May to the outside. They tried an overload blitz to his top right side. Ball came right out. Clock stops until they move the chains.
Leidner, swing pass Smith. Smith trying to get to the edge. He's got the edge and nudged out of bounds by Jamerson at the 36-yard line. So a pickup of four on the play. Clock stops 3:54 in the fourth quarter.
Plenty of time. No need to panic. Just continue to pick. If they're giving you the underneath, take the underneath.
Clock will wind on the ready for play as it's now going. Second down and six at the 36-yard line.
Plenty of time.
Leidner again to the outside, breaking a tackle is Hart, and Hart gets close to the first down marker. He's a yard short at the 41.
But he does stop the clock because he gets out of bounds. Again, plenty of time, no need to rush. Leidner's in a rhythm right now.
Third down and one at the 41. Leidner on the give. Running room for Smith, and Rodney Smith has a first down. Clock stops with the first down at the 48-yard line. 3:31 to go in the fourth.
Nice job by the offensive line of getting set right away, ready for play. Everybody's set. Very efficient.
On first down, Leidner takes some contact again, airing it for the sideline, and it's incomplete.
Good coverage. Good coverage there by Hillary. Right on top of it. Still couldn't get away from him. He used the sideline exactly the way you want to be able to use it. See how he forces him to the sideline? That's your extra defender. He cased the inside away. Really well done.
So now with the incompletion, clock holds at 3:20 to go in the fourth. Minnesota still has two timeouts. They would like to save those for perhaps another defensive series if they need it. After a score, that's a long way down the road.
Got a lot of time left.
Leidner, pumps pressure coming. Leidner got away, now he's going to run. And Leidner with a good scramble to the 44. Got to hurry, though. Clock continuing to run, 3:06 and counting, and it's third down.
He's still good. You got third and fourth down if they need it.
Third and two right now, under 3 minutes to go. Leidner. And the give to Smith, and Smith didn't get it, and a flag down.
It'll stop the clock.
But is it 10 yards against Minnesota?
Holding. Offense number 71. 10-yard penalty, repeat third down.
That's Tyler the freshman, Moore. Tyler Moore, the center.
Stay tuned for the regular season finale of the State Farm postgame report. Dave, Jerry, and Howard will get you caught up on a busy final day in the Big Ten. Third down and 12, back of the goal for 46 after the penalty. Clock starts. Pressure coming.
Leidner throws.
Got Wolitarski out there, and the pass is incomplete. Natrell Jamerson on the coverage, and it's fourth down.
That's a bad throw. Wolitarski had Jamerson beat to the top. He needed to put that thing over the top. Instead, he underthrew it. There was some contact there. Did not play the ball. Hand in the face. I can hear the boos, as you well can, but they didn't throw the flag. So fourth and 12. They've got to make this.
Fourth down and 12. Four-man rush, pressure coming. Leidner gets away from the first man. He's in trouble, and he cannot get rid of it to Smith in time. And the Gophers turn it over to the Badgers on downs. Chris Orr, the first guy to get to Leidner. And then the pressure came in waves with Alec James and Vince Beagle.
Yeah, Beagle was the first one there. Beagle, and then James finished it off. Beagle made him step up. James was able to get the hands wrapped around him and forced it. James working from the inside, coming all the way around. That's Chris Orr was the first one, I'm sorry. And then Beagle.
That Now Wisconsin with the ball, the 10-point lead, 2:39 to go. Minnesota has two timeouts left. From the 46, first down. Ogunbowale with the carry. A flag is down.
That'll stop the clock and bring it back.
Holding. Offense number 63. 10-yard penalty repeat, first down.
So they'll back him up, but they're not putting time back on that clock right now. And so it's first down and long, but you lost a few seconds there in the process.
And for Wisconsin, it's not a big deal. So you're gonna run this. You don't care if you get the first down now anyway. You're just gonna run as much time off the clock as you can.
And the clock
is running.
So the clock starts, and now you've got a chance to burn off another 20 seconds or so. So now it's first down. The clock is running, and Wisconsin will wait as long as they can. Stavi Snap still with five on the play clock as Ogunbowale is hit in the backfield and dropped by Nick Rawlis. And now the timeout is utilized by Minnesota. They have one timeout remaining.
Stavi needed to use that last 6 seconds. Take it down and snap it with one to go.
2:08 to go. It is second down. Down and distance, not really that big a deal for Wisconsin. They'd love to get a first down, be able to just take a knee and end this thing. But right now, second and 21 at the 43. Their goal is to just get the clock moving again.
Well, it's pretty simple for Paul Chris. All he has to do is look down that list and look for the 22-yard run. It's in there somewhere. He just has to pick it.
But after that hold on the running play, because it wasn't an incomplete pass, that allowed Wisconsin to burn those extra seconds there before snapping it after the hold was accepted. So now it's second down and 21 at the 43. Taiwan Deal with the carry. And Deal fighting out to the 45 before he's driven back. And now the final timeout is used after Nick Rawlis makes the tackle. Well, the axe is not injured. It is just on the training table awaiting some attention at the end of this game. It's been in Wisconsin's possession for 11 straight games. The axe is great. I imagine the slab of bacon would have been equally as good to play for, if not better in some ways. It was created in 1930. That slab of bacon disappeared in the early 40s, found decades later at Camp Randall in a storage room, and they cleaned it out.
Kevin, right now in this situation, is just hand the ball off and then let that clock run down as far down as you're going to go. Even take the penalty, doesn't matter, and then kick it away.
Third down and 19. Gophers out of timeouts. Motion from Fumagalli. A little bit of difficulty with the handoff to Deal, and Deal makes the most of it, gets out just shy of the 49. Rawlis again on the stop, and the clock will run now before the Wisconsin punt. Minnesota cannot stop it. Gophers are going to get the football back, but no timeouts, down 10 late in the fourth.
Yeah, with about a buck 15, maybe a little bit under that, they'll get it. And they need two scores.
It is a steep hill to climb indeed for Minnesota to win back the axe and make themselves bowl eligible. Deontay Harden will let that one bounce.
Good kick.
It's going to burn some time as Harden pounces on it to end that one. As he watched it roll, seconds were ticking off the clock, and with 1:07 to play, Minnesota has it back after the 43-yard punt at the 8-yard line.
And so now how you defend this? So you let them, you give them everything underneath. Doesn't matter. They can drive the whole field. It doesn't make a bit of difference. You can't get beat over the top, so you're going to keep people on top of coverage. And you want your linebackers to drop and get depth. Let everything happen in front of you. Come up and make the tackle. No blitzes. You go with a 3 or 4 man rush. It doesn't really matter with the rush. All that matters is the clock.
Leitner. And on first down, he was looking in the direction of Nick Hart, who had slipped down, and a flag is down.
In the secondary.
Right in the area where Hart was on the ground.
It stops the clock.
Pass interference, defense number 50. Ball be placed at the spot of the foul, automatic first down.
That's Chris Orr, freshman linebacker. Yeah, I'd say that's a...
On first down, pressure coming, and Leitner almost throws the pick to T.J. Watt.
Let me just tell you something. That's Chris Orr, who came on the pressure. Dave Aranda, the defensive coordinator, not a hesitation at all for blitzing and bringing pressure. He went man coverage and brought guys off the edge. And it worked. Orr was able to get the hit. Here's another blitz.
Second down and 10 to the sideline, incomplete, looking for May. Coverage from Hillary. Clock stops, 55 seconds to play in the fourth, and now third and 10.
Dave Aranda is not afraid with his guys in coverage. So he just thinks they're not running away from him at all. So he'll take this chance. Now here's his own.
Pressure again, and Leitner is drilled by Vince Beagle. 8th sack of the year for Beagle. Now 4th down, clock running. 19 yards to go for the first. The game and the season on the line right here for Minnesota. Leitner hit once more, airing it out, and the pass is intercepted by McAvoy along the sidelines. It is a pick. It is his second of the day. It is his 6th of the year, and Wisconsin is going to keep Paul Bunyan's axe for a 12th straight season. Defense that has carried this Badger team all year long steps up one last time to close out the regular season. Stavi takes a knee, and the Badgers about to end the regular season 9-3 and 6-2 in Big Ten play. Wisconsin victorious over Minnesota for the 12th straight season, 31-21. Badgers win it here in Minneapolis. And the axe stays in Madison. It's over! It's over! Unprecedented dominance in this series. As the Badgers make their way down to do some chopping. Let's check in downstairs with Lisa Byington.
The 12th straight time that you've beaten a rival, the first time you've done it as a head coach, what does it mean to hold serve here in this rivalry game for the Badgers?
Well, I mean, certainly winning any game is a big deal, and the rivalry is special. So it means a lot because of who the guys are, and to finish the regular season the way that we did, awfully proud of them. Happy for them.
250-plus rush yards. It was something that you established real early, made a difference in this game. What did you see from your running back, Daria Gumbiav? It's cold. I can't spit it out. And your 4 freshman offensive linemen.
Well, I thought that really the line, tight ends, I thought we did a nice job particularly in the first half running the football. And I thought Daria ran with a purpose. I thought Taiwan gave us some good carries, and it was, we took advantage of some turnovers, defensively. I thought we did a nice job, and I'm just proud of this group, and it was fun to come up here and be able to come out here with a win.
All right, thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Got to get Lisa in, get her warmed up. It is a cold evening in Minneapolis, but those guys don't even know it. 31-21 Wisconsin. They are victorious from TCF Bank Stadium. That'll wrap up our football season at BTN. Dave, Howard, and Jerry will wrap up a busy final week from our Chicago studios. So for the final time this season, for Matt Millen, Lisa Byington, and our entire BTN production crew, I'm Kevin Kugler saying goodbye from Minneapolis. Wisconsin keeps the axe.